too bad I don't have time to stop and look at some of these views. But we'll get lots of views on Manitoulin if we make the boat. 11:29 now. Beautiful scenery. Too bad I didn't leave about an hour earlier. I think that's what it's like with spontaneous. Fly by the seat of your pants. You deal with the non-planning. Already this is going to have to be multiple videos for this one. Because it's just too many amazing views. Way too many. And so I just keep hitting the camera and there's just too much good stuff. I may even do you all a favor and just blot out my voice and put music. Would you like that? I missed the turn. That's not good when you're on a time restriction. Beautiful road, but I don't think it's the one I'm supposed to be on. We may have to boot up the GPS. Amazing road. Turn somewhere. It's funny because I've done this trip before, but I was just cruising along and thought I was following the right road. Well, it doesn't say no exit, so we're gonna keep going and hope for the best. Oh, Kemble Road. And it runs north out of Kemble. Maybe I was supposed to turn left there or something at that stop sign. At least it's paved. Who knows, maybe I found a shortcut. And of course this normally wouldn't be such a big deal if I wasn't trying to get somewhere in time. I actually like getting lost when I'm on the bike. 24. This is 24 it is. Well, my instinct tells me I'm heading towards Highway 6. This is okay if I hit that, then it's a straight run up. It'll be a windy run and less scenic, but I will get back on track time-wise. Well, it slowed me down, hoping this is going into Big Bay. Oh, practicing my bends. I'm definitely in town. I just got to figure out where it goes up the road to get on rear one again. There it is, railroad one. I'm assuming this is north. It better be north or I'm screwed. So we're back on track. That was pretty awesome going through there. Maybe when I'm coming back, I'll have time and don't have any boat to catch. Take my time and stop and do a little more filming around there. In the meantime, I got a boat to catch. Will he make it? I figure if the boat leaves at 1:30, the absolute latest I could be there is 1 o'clock, and they recommend sooner than that. I do not have a reservation, so I'm just taking a chance that there's room to get one bike on there. And if that's the case, I'll get on the boat. It's like we got the trike ahead. I ain't got time to be friendly. He's going slower than I need to go to get there on time. Hope he doesn't think I gave him the finger. I gave him a wave. The old two-finger biker wave. To be a pretty nice day. Oh my god, I am so screwed. I just saw water appear on my left. And that meant, when I got lost to that road and I came out and found Gray Road 1, that I turned the wrong freaking way. And then I'm heading south. Now I am really, really screwed for time. I don't even know if I'm going to make it now. I've turned around. I was heading south for all maybe 10 minutes, so that means I've lost 20 minutes. 11:46. I should have just went the friggin' highway route. Like I said, I love going the back ways and the scenic routes, but it's easy to take a wrong road. When you don't have to be anywhere, it's awesome. I don't mind it, but I'm so screwed now. I'm trying to catch this boat. And here I was going the wrong way. Because there is nowhere on Gray Road 1, if you're heading north, that there's water on your left. And I don't have a compass, and I'm really seriously thinking of getting one. Never did boot up the GPS. You know, that's for if I'm lost or going to a specific destination, trying to find an address or something. Not for joyriding. Oh, I am so screwed. What this means is I have to pretty much speed and hope that I don't get a ticket or get pulled over. And I have to be there within an hour, max. What I get for taking the wrong way. I'll let you know how it goes. I'm back into Big Bay. I missed the sign before I could hit the button. So I must have come out here and turned right, thinking I was coming out there, that side, and turning right. So now I am back to where I started, and we are way behind. This is going to be a friggin' miracle if I make it in time now. I'm still not even in Wyreton yet, and it's almost noon. If I get a ticket, it's going to make things go even worse. And I know there's the odd cop along here too. They like to camp these back roads more so than the highways. So I can't push it too fast. My one advantage I do have along here is there has been almost no traffic. There's been like nobody. And that is very helpful for me trying to make up time. I can speed a little bit, watching for the bends ahead in the hills. Never go around a bend or a hill speeding, because that's where you could get radared as well. first. That's kind of like using the rhythm method. Not that reliable. And then we got these little places with their 50 zones, which doesn't help. My goodness, how are we going to get there in time? That's a good question. We're just going to have to try. If I don't make it, then... I took that a little too fast. I suppose a real experienced racer would just lean real hard and make it, but I'm not. But ABS brakes come in handy.